Tell me to tell your neighbor, evolve.
Evolve.
Tell another neighbor, evolve.
Evolve.
Tell your pastor, pastor, evolve now.
Pastor, evolve.
A lot of us, we are going to be evolving gloriously.
Yeah.
Evolve just means it's a transformation. It's a changing from one level of glory to another. You are evolving. Sometimes it's a gradual process. But whatever it is, we shall evolve.
Yeah.
In the book of Mark chapter 5:25-34. Mark chapter 5:25-34 is a story that you know very well of a woman with the issue of blood. This woman, she was once very sick for 12 years. She was passing out blood. Even when women do it for a month, they are not saying a month, few days, it's not very easy. 12 years, I could imagine how she would be looking. I could imagine how sickly, how weak she would be. 12 years consistently passing out blood. So I said that she has spent everything. Meaning that maybe she was once upon a time rich, but she could not have a solution. But solution came to her that particular day. Today is the beginning of great solutions in your life. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years and has suffered many things of many physicians and has spent all that she had and was nothing better but rather grew worse. When she had heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that virtue had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? And his disciples said unto him, thou seest the multitude thronging thee, and seest thou who touched me? And he looked round about to see her that had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. And he said unto her daughter, what did he say? Thy faith hath made thee whole. Go in peace and behold all that plague. I'm praying that whatever you have been suffering or mingling with, today shall be the day of your solution.
Amen.
It just helps us to do it. Evolve. I told you that evolve is a gradual changing from one state, usually onto a better state. That is the plan of God for our life. You know, when we were in school, they taught us about the evolution of man. I don't know whether they also told you that man started from ape, being ape, then not gradually evolved to becoming the human being that we are seeing now. Being ape, that it was like this, then it was not evolving and it now became man. I don't know whether they taught you in school, minus me or minus you. We did not start from that. Because the Bible said that God created Adam. If Adam happened to be like him, he would not be looking for helpmeet. The Bible said that there was no helpmeet among, he named all the animals in the book of Genesis chapter 2:19-20. God brought all the animals to him and he named all the beasts of the field. But there was no helpmeet for him, according to the scripture. Then God now caused him to have a deep sleep and took a rib from him and made that rib to becoming woman and now brought the woman to Adam. By the exclamation of Adam, he's showing us that he had not seen that kind of a creature before. So if he was also looking like ape, You know, the woman. He was surprised. But that is just my own thoughts. But that is, by the way, in this scripture that we read, we saw there that this woman had been sick for 12 years. But she had been going to different physicians, from one physician to another. And the Bible says that she grew worse. And many things, many of us are like that. We have issues in our life. We have been moving from one place to the other. The people that we thought that would solve our problem. And I'm sure many of us, they keep on recommending us to different people because of the situation in our lives. And they will be giving us testimony of what those people have done. Yes, when you go, by the time you go, disappointment. God is going to meet with you this morning. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. She went from one physician to another. One physician to another. As you can see, that they are demonstrating now. One physician, yet our issue of blood continue. Passing out blood, day after day. Week after week, month after month, year after year, year one, year two, year three, year four, year 12. But one thing I love about this woman, she did not give up. She did not give up because that was the thing that was making her to think in her heart that if only I could touch the hem of Jesus Christ. She was listening to the stories of what Jesus Christ had done. The Bible said that she had heard of Jesus Christ. This month, I want to appeal to you that you should take time to hear. At this point in time, she touched Jesus Christ. When she touched Jesus Christ asked the disciple, who taught me? And the other disciple, they were saying that, you are seeing a lot of people, everybody has been touching you. He said, no, somebody touched me. And by the time he looked and fixed the gaze on her, she was trembling and afraid, and she owned up that she was the one. But Jesus Christ did not rebuke her. Jesus Christ commended her that her faith had made her whole. I'm prophesying into your life that the faith that you require to get every blessing that you have been looking for, God will activate in your life. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Put your hands together for this wonderful thing. Amen. What I'm trying to say, somebody will say that what has God got to do with the story of this woman? The woman was once upon a time sick for 12 years, but she evolved unto becoming whole. She was looking for the solution outside. God is telling us in this house, or wherever you are watching us, that the solution is not outside, it's inside. Jesus Christ did not say, I've always been hearing the preaching, or hearing or thinking that it was Jesus Christ that actually healed her. Yes, he had the power to heal her. The power of God has never changed, it's always there till tomorrow. Whether you are getting the solution or not, is there. You're not getting healed, you're not getting what you are looking for. Does not mean that the power is there. In fact, you have seen other people getting what they are trusting God for to tell you that the power is there. But what we use to draw the power is in you. Faith. Jesus Christ said that, not my faith, daughter, thy faith. And our faith will not be outside of our life. Meaning that all the while, what she needed had been inside. But she needed to activate it by doing something. The Bible said, when you read it very well, tell me that she had heard of Jesus Christ. And when she heard of Jesus Christ, her faith that had been there, because God had given everybody a measure of faith, God activated and said, if only I could just touch his clothes, I will be made whole. It was that faith. And God was trying to point our attention that don't be looking at me, that it's not my clothes. Were people not if this was my clothes, everybody that touched me that day would get their food, but all of them still went back. They did not get anything. But what made our own was our faith. This month, God is telling you, ensure that you activate your faith. How do you do this? The word of God. Don't miss any opportunity to be in church or any setting that the word of God is going to be preached, or you reading the word of God by yourself. Romans chapter 10 verse 17. Romans 10 17. Faith coming by how? By hearing. And hearing the word of God. And you know what? You cannot please God without faith. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6. Hebrews 11 verse 6. It's in you. Stop looking out for people. Don't go for pastor, geo, or go to one mountain or the other. Build your faith, develop your faith inside, and God will orchestrate situations that will deliver that thing you are looking for. All the places that you have looked for. This woman, she went to different physicians, but she was going worse. So those physicians, they look like it. Some of the people that you are not done to, they look like the one, but at the end of the day, you discover that. Look unto, David said in the book of Psalm 121, verses 1 and 2, he said that, I will look unto the healed. From where is coming?
My help
coming from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Look unto Jesus. This month of May is very important. It's in you. There's a story that I told the Feka people. Feka people happen to be ex-secondary school students. They called us last week that we should come and minister to them. So I told them a story of an eagle that became an orphan. The eagle lost the mother and father. You know, eagle also lost the mother and father. The Lord, and the eagle was still, he was still very small. I just glided down the hilly rock to the bottom, the base of the hill. And somebody came along and saw this baby eagle. This creature looked like chicken, and took it and gave it to one farmer who had the chicken back. And I said that this one does not really look like it. I said that it's chicken, just put it among your. Are you not happy to even have additional? That one put it among the chicken. And the eagle started developing, but it is one that it was bigger than other chicken. But it was mingling with other chicken, pecking for food, worms, and could not really fly because you did not see anybody fly, any chicken flying around it. And the eagle was playing with other chicken. The eagle just saw one eagle flying very high, majestically. Boom, boom. He said, what? What kind of bird is that? The one of the chickens that I forget, that is an eagle. We are not like that. Don't worry. Don't be looking at it. We cannot be like that. Forget about it so that you will not give yourself hypertension. I guess. Forget about that. And sometimes we go through such things. And the eagle truly forgot about that. But one day, somebody came to that chicken barn. Happen to be a naturalist. Naturalists are the people that they are so obsessed with nature. They want nature to be restored the way it was. So that I don't think this is a chicken. The farmer said that the chicken is that big. No, this is a very powerful bird that can fly so high. So that this one cannot fly. And say, okay, I will test it now. I will tell you that this is an eagle. The eagle is not meant to be with this thing. And took the eagle, put it on top of a high place. And I said, eagle, you have been built to fly. Now fly, now push it. It didn't just flew and came down near the chicken again. And started there. The farmer said, you see, I told you, this is a chicken. He went, the next day the man came back, who could not rest. He said, you know what, let me take it higher again. And I took it to the top of the roof. And I said, you are an eagle. You are meant to fly. And just pushed it a little bit. And the eagle saw other chicken around, and the owls just went there, just landed. He was not satisfied. The third day, he now told the man, please give me one more chance to test this thing. And I took it to the very top of the hill. Top of the hill that he could not even see any of the chicken, could not even see the house. And I said that, eagle, you have been built to fly. What will make you fly is inside of you. You have not discovered it. You need to express yourself. And the eagle was afraid. Don't push it in the beach to don't rescue himself. I just did like this, and he just saw himself moving on a little bit. Did it again, and very shortly he started gliding and now feeling it. Many of us are like that. What God has not designed you to be an inferior person. You are looking at other people that are shining when your own glory is supposed to be greater than them. Allow that is in you this month. Ensure you bring out what God has put in. Evolve gloriously. God has not made you to be in the cocoon. He has not made you to be a caterpillar. It's a faith. But you need to gloriously evolve. One of it is faith that we have seen. Jesus Christ told the woman, your faith, not my faith. Your faith has made you whole. And somebody's faith. Is not my faith will not be in you, my faith will not be in you, my faith will be in me, your own faith will be in you. Meaning that all the while what she needed has been in her, which has been looking out for other things. I'm prophesying that this month, that which God has put in you to showcase his glory to the world shall be made manifest. Let's rise to our feet and pray and say, Father, like never before, help me to evolve gloriously. Like never before, help me to gloriously evolve. Thank you. Blessed be your lady. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Almighty Father, we thank you for your word that has come. You have told us that this is the month that we evolve, gloriously evolve. Let there be manifestation in all our lives. We that are here and our brethren that are online, wherever they are in the world. Father, let the anointing to evoke glory rest upon all of us. Amen. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.